Hi, thank you for joining us today. My name is Devin, and today I'll be giving you a walkthrough on how to install the workspace as well as how to configure it. So I'll be walking you through how to download the software from the trade, the pool hub, and how to have it installed and configured. So let's go. So here we have the trade, the pool website. You can go anywhere on the website, whether it is program, funded phase, or anything, but you should see the sign up option here once you're using a PC. So we're going to select sign up. I already have an account created. And once you select sign up, if you don't already have an account, let's say you're signing up for the demo account and you don't already have the demo account, you're going to select the option that says new order. You're going to go to whether you want to go on be a part of the day trading evaluation or the swing trading evaluation, you're going to go to that section. So I'm going to the day trading option. And here I'm only seeing these options because I've already signed up for the demo. But let's say I never signed up for the demo, I would see an option here that says $1 million. And it instead of saying ultimate or mini, super, extra, it would show demo, $1 million. Right? It is different from everything else because it is the only one that says demo. The others here are the actual evaluation themselves. So seeing that we already have an account, we're going to go back to overview and we're going to select the option that says dashboard to open up the dashboard. Now on the dashboard, it's loading, is where we'll see the option to download the software. So for most of the traders who would come on and they would say, hey, I cannot find my credentials, here is where you would go to find your credentials. Let me do that again. So you hover over this key icon here that says credential, and you would select that option. And once you do, you would see the credentials. So here you have login and the password. Now, this isn't really important. It's a demo account that I'm just using. For you guys can use that to familiarize yourself with the software. But here's where you would see the login credentials. Also, these are the various softwares that we offer, as well as you do have a web version now. So for the if you have a Windows device, you would select this option here that says Windows. You're gonna select that Windows option and it's going to start downloading a package into your browser, which would then be installed onto your, which would then be downloaded to your PC. And you're going to go to your file explorer, right? And then you're going to pull up the most recent file explorer, the most recent file, go to download it. You're going to pull up the most recent file. Let me do that so you guys can see. So let me just select the Windows option here. And you see it's now having it downloaded. And let's just give it some time to download, right? Okay. So while that's downloading, we're going to pull up our file explorer because there is where we're going to find it. And once you pull up our file explorer, let's just refresh. Here it is. So we would select this, double click. And for most of you guys who already have it installed on the PC already, you might see an option that says remove or restore. If it's already there, let me show you. So seeing that I already have the software installed on my PC. So what I'm going to see, given that it's already installed, I'm going to see the option to repair or remove. If you guys already have it installed, you don't need to select either of these options. You can just exit off. Are you sure you want to cancel the trade the pool installation? Yes, you don't need to cancel it because it's already installed on the PC. Now you're going to go to your search bar on your PC and you're gonna type in trade the pool, right? I'm using two screens here. Here you go. So I'm gonna type in trade the pool and it's gonna pull it up and you're just gonna select open because once it's already installed, if it's not installed, then you just follow the process to have it installed. Now, I'm waiting for it to come up here. Just give me a few minutes. Takes a while to come up. Okay, great. So once this comes up, this is what I'm going to do. I'm going to select this here. I'm going to copy that. I'm going to paste it into here. I'm going to copy this as well. I'm going to also paste it in here. And it's logging in. Okay.
So it's logged in. Great. So once it's logged in, this is the default workspace. And the default workspace is called Trade the Pool workspace. Now, in previous videos I've made, which I believe a lot of you guys will watch because you want to familiarize yourself with the software, you would see where I showed you how to place an order using the market, right? As well as how to place an order using the chart order entry, which I'm going to show you how to do chart order entry.
Yeah.
Now, we see where we have this YouTube panel. For most of you guys who would want to have that removed, this is how you will do that. You will go down to this section here, and you will select this lock to unlock the workspace. Once that's done, you're going to go back over to the panel, and you're going to have it X'd off. So you no longer have that YouTube video playing, right? Now, for most of you guys, you could either use this default workspace, which is pretty much, it contains everything. But I figure, you know, most traders come on, they want to customize their own workspace. So today I'll be showing you how to customize your own workspace. So we'll select that plus sign there and it will open up a new workspace. Now, the first thing I want to pull up when I open a new workspace is my chart, right? Because the chart is the most important thing when you're trading. And there it is, it will pull up a chart in the default time frame. On the chart will be a 5-minute time frame over 20 days. Now, we want to add some more things to our workspace. What are some of the things that we'll be using as traders? We're going to need to see the filled orders panel. So we want to see when our orders are filled, right? So that is the order once it's closed out. It's not an open position, meaning it's an open position, but let's say you place a trade and that order was filled, and then you close the trade and then the order was filled. This is where you would go to see that, right? Now, we also will pull up our positions panel because it's very important for it to see our open positions. So once we have our filled orders open and our positions panel open, some more important panels that we will open is the one working orders, which is very important. It shows the orders that are in the queue. Select terminal again, and we open the positions balance, which will open the value. This will show us the value of the position that we have open. So let's say we have 1,000 shares on a stock that is selling for $10. That's a position. The net exposure is 10,000. The position value is $10,000. And the net exposure would be like the position adjusting for gain or loss. One more important panel that we're going to open is the order history. Now, this gives us a detailed overview of when the order was created, what type of order it is, whether it is a market order or a limit order. This is very important. So we currently have majority of our panels open. The next thing we'll open is the market depth. Now, I use the market depth to see the time and sales. It's very important data. And the market depth is the same thing as the level two. Now, you guys can decide to use the market depth, or you can decide to use a time and sales, or any panel that you would like to open on the software. You just select terminal and they're here, as well as you can go to tools and it will show you the high, low list, as well as the gainers and losers. And we have the RSS, which is news. Now we have the most important information open, right? Now, I'll show you how to navigate this workspace and some various nuances. So first thing first, we will right click here and we will go to settings, right? And now we will go to chart order entry. And this, what I'm showing you now is how to set up a chart order entry. So you select that option. And once you select that option, you see it's quick trading highlighted, similar to the hotkeys. You'd select those. We're going to select all of them, hot buttons. And then we're going to select apply. Then once we do that, we'll have here a number of shares. So what this allows us to do is this allows us to buy on the ask, sell on the bid, buy on the bid, sell on the bid, sell market, buy market. And once you have a position open, we can either cancel the buy, cancel the sell, cancel all, or reverse the position. Now, I know most of the traders would like to have like a default setting where, you know, you are putting in a position and instead of having to type it out, you can just go to default, just click the drop down, click 1,000 shares, click 900 shares, and whether sell or buy real quick. It's pretty convenient to use. To set that up, you select set default, and here you would see where you can set it up. So if you want to buy 10 shares, you want to set that to 10, we'd select OK, and it's 10. Now, let's say I want to buy on the ask. I want to buy Tesla on the ask. I would just say buy, and it opens trade immediately for Tesla on the ask. If I want to close out a trade on Tesla on the ask, on the bid, I would sell bid. So I sell 10 shares of Tesla on the bid, right? Now, look, when fill orders, it's showing the orders here. Let me do that again. So here I can just buy 10 shares of Tesla on the ask, and I would go to positions, and here I would see my open position where the open price is $219 and the net P&L, this is the profit or loss on the unrealized gain or loss on the trade. And this is showing the current price that the stock is trading at. Now, we have no working orders because the order was filled immediately. And here we see the position balance where it's showing us the net exposure is $2,198.80, right? Now, order history would show us here we see I have a buy. It shows where the buy was created. The order was created and it showed when the order was filled. The order was filled immediately right as it was created because it was a limit order on the ask. Now, let us sell that position. And there you see, it creates the order and then it fills the order. But then if we go to fill order, it shows that the order was just filled, right? So using those tabs, you're able to see the data. It's very convenient because you can see when your order is filled, see when your order is created, and see when your order is closed out, what price it was closed out at, and what price, sorry, and what time. Now, for most of you guys who are using indicators, I'm going to show you how to add an indicator to the chart. And this is where you could go to add any amount of indicator you want. So you would right click here. You would go to indicator, add indicator. And then I would just type in the ATR for average true range, select that and open. And it'll open the ATR indicator on Tesla, which we see it's showing the data right now. Now, you can add any indicator that you want because we basically provide all the indicators available for trading, and you can also import indicators as well, which could be covered in another video. Now, here we've basically covered how to set up the workspace and how to basically open and close an order on the bid on the ask, right? Now, this is very important information as well. So let's say I open 10 shares of Tesla, I'm on the ask, right? Let me close that out. Hold on. We're going to close that out of the market order. Yeah. So let's say I wanted to set, open the trade with a stop loss. I could open a bracket order or I could just open it one side. So here we have a stop loss. Once you select that stop loss there, it's supposed to be highlighted. Now, this is points. So this is basically, if I put $1, hold on. If I clear this out and I put one and I open a trade on, I buy, let me put two because Tesla has an ATR of 55 cents. So let me put two and I buy Tesla at on the ask, it will automatically open it with a stop loss on Tesla for at this at $2 from the entry price, right? And the take profit would basically be the same thing. So let me just cancel the open order and cancel this as well. If I now open 10 shares, buy 10 shares of Tesla, I want to open a bracket order where I want to open it with 10 shares on, sorry, I want to open it with both a take profit and a stop loss. So I would just clear this out and I put my stop loss, my take profit, 6 points away, which would be $6 away from the open price, right? So that's from the open price. And here we have it. Now, you won't see it because it's far away from the entry price. Let me just close that out. So let's do this again. So let me go, instead of going $6 out, let me go $2 out as well. And let's buy right there. So we see our take profit and we see our stop loss. And it basically, if the trade goes here, it's going to close out at a profit because it's going to be a limit order right there. And if we go to market order here, we see it. So we see the stop loss and the take profit as well. Both of them are sell orders. So let us close that out. Now you know how to set a bracket order when using the chart order entry, as well as how to set a stop loss and a take profit by themselves. Right, you can change this here to good till cancel or day. Also, I'm going to show you how to link the panels. Now we have the chart order entry. Let's say right here we have NVDA. Right? Now we add NVIDIA there. Now we notice that the stock on NVIDIA, on the chart is different from the one on the market depth. The reason for that is because the panels are not linked. So what we'll now do, we see here that the link on in the chart is yellow. So we'll just switch this over to yellow as well. We'll select this chain icon and we'd select that and it would link the panels, right? So basically what this does, it links the panels together. So basically that's how you set up the workspace and install the software to have it working on your PC, right? Thanks.